I got my mouth full of PB&J. Haven't been getting any bites. I guess this is what you call leading by example. He was up in that eddy. Again, we're at the end of this pool. This is a known winter hole. There he is. Oh, he's nice. That's a nice late March smallmouth. Okay, we got a nice 4 pound, 2 ounce, 20 inch Rappahannock River smallmouth here. We'll go ahead and let him go. And he was right at the terminus of this winter pool. In the, you know, at the end of the winter season, they're gonna move to the tops and the bottoms of these pools. And right before they start moving out and looking for their spawning grounds, which are going to be areas with a lot of islands, basically anywhere that you're going to have current breaks, places where that they can deposit their eggs, and they're not going to be blown out with a high water event. But before they make it to those spots, in the winter pools, the ends of them, and all the way up at the top. This 20 incher was at the end of it, probably staging to move downward to find good spawning grounds down that way. So I felt good.
At certain times of year, you have these really prime opportunities to get into a mess of big fish clustered into tight groups. And winter is certainly one of those, but especially the winter hole exodus, where they're all leaving the winter holes in search of spawning grounds, is an opportunity to get them when they're actively feeding. This was the 20 incher I got today. That was at the tail end of the pool. And I'm going to show you a bird's eye view. First, I want to show you a couple shots from my book. Two real nice fish that I caught from this same pool, but instead of the tail, where I got the one today, he was right down here. They were up at the head of the pool, the same wintering pool. Usually, you get some ledges here, you get some deeper water along this bank, and in the winter, this bank right here is really prime wintering habitat. But they'll move down into, you know, like today, they move down into this little rock garden. They're pushing down, they get as far as they can in the direction of the spawning grounds without actually jumping all at once. And that's where they're going to be actively feeding. The end of the pool and up at the head of it. Right up here, you got another rock garden here, another island. This is going to be prime spawning habitat up in here. And where I got those, the two from the book, was right up in here on this bank. Again, they're pushing up towards the head. They're getting as far as they can get before it gets real shallow, and they gotta work real hard to get up into, you know, pretty marginal water. I've caught them up in at the base of the rock garden a little bit, but this is really the last example of deep water before they go ahead and launch and head on upstream, the same way that the tail of this pool was the last deep water before they would move on downstream. So winter hole exodus, it's a big deal, and in at my latitude, it's usually end of March. The two from the book shots, that was March 27th, and today we have March 23rd, so right around the same time of year.
I don't have a net today, so I have to do it the old-fashioned way and lip it. It's a problem.
Same spot as at 20, wasn't it?
Behind that rock, right inside the eddy line.
They do cluster right at the ends and the heads of these winter pools. Late March. He's a nice one.
We just got three fish in short succession, and this guy's going to go back and grow to be a 22.
The clips you are watching will be part of Blue Ridge Kayak Fishing's four-part seasonal patterns DVDs on river smallmouth. The first seasonal DVD covering summer patterns will be released in late April 2011. To learn the basis of pattern development, get a copy of River Kayak Fishing Skills, a River Runner's Lesson Plan. To learn more about the best conditions for trophy river smallmouth, get a copy of In Pursuit of Trophy Smallmouth Bass, My Life in a Kayak, available through BlueRidgeKayakFishing.com or KayakBassFishing.com. Thank you for watching.